This video is the last in a series about what the prophetic Psalms in the Bible tell us concerning the second coming of Jesus. We will now combine everything these Psalms tell us so that we can see the big picture the prophetic passages in the Psalms paint. The 12 Psalms in the series show the following. Because God will be with his own in the calamities of the great tribulation, they are not to fear. Amid the turmoil of the end time, the prospect of the coming of the Lord will cause great rejoicing among God's people who are on the earth, as well as those who have died and are in heaven. When Jesus finally comes after the great tribulation, he will appear in glory. He will come loudly and with fire, causing the mountains to melt. When Jesus comes in the clouds, he will be visible to all the nations. He will gather his saints to himself and proceed to Jerusalem. When Jesus arrives, he will execute heads of state in his wrath against those who oppose his return. He will subdue, decimate, and burn up his enemies and destroy the Antichrist. Jesus will bring spiritual restoration to Israel and show mercy to Jerusalem. There in Jerusalem, Jesus will sit and judge all the peoples of the world with righteousness. He will be wedded to his people, whose souls he has preserved, and he will build up the city of Jerusalem. From there, Jesus will reign in his kingdom that he will set up on the earth. Jesus will rule as king over all the nations on the earth with strength and power together with his people. He will rule with righteousness and truth, and his kingdom will be full of peace and justice. All nations in the whole world and their leaders will fear, serve, and give honor to the Lord Jesus, and they will exalt God. Finally, we are told that the glorious kingdom Jesus will establish when he returns to earth will last forever. We close with Psalm 118, verse 26, which says, with regard to the return of Jesus, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord."